What is mansplaining? Well, it's when a man explains something to you in a manner that feels patronizing or condescending. Did I just do it? Is this okay? I mean, this is a video. It's a tutorial video, so all my videos are about explaining something, right? Okay, I know I'm not a woman, but I know what this sounds like. And you know, men do it to other men as well. Look, while it typically seems geared towards women, it's also about that guy who just doesn't know how to be considerate to others and puts himself on a pedestal and talks to anyone in a pompous way. This is when a man assumes that he knows more about your own life than you do. Like he knows what's best for you. He knows how you should work out or run your business or dress or eat, etc. So in this video, I'll talk about how women can handle mansplaining, and in another video, I'll talk to men about how they can be more aware of that behavior and stop it. By the way, you can download the key steps in this video by clicking on the link below in the description. Okay, let me just say, sometimes this doesn't always have to do with men only. While it's more prominent and we clearly live in a patriarchal society, ladies can do this too. Not quite as often, but we are guilty of delivering unsolicited advice sometimes, especially when we feel we know a better way. And have I been guilty of doing this myself? Oh yeah, I was put in my place, sometimes in better ways than others, and with an apology, I learned to be more aware of it. Plus, I am a father to a wonderful daughter, and my tolerance for anyone mansplaining her, close to zero. Okay, so let's look at ways to handle this. Confronting mansplaining can be hard, but no matter what, you need to confront it head on. Be assertive and do it right away. Don't wait to do it later or through an email or through a text or anything else. You might be accommodating in a moment, but will build resentment later about what you wish you could have done or said right away. This can build bitterness over time and then come back to bite you when you lash out with comments that are too harsh due to a pent-up anger because of something you didn't resolve right away. Nope, you need to do it right away. And if that person is mansplaining you in front of a team or a group, then respond to it right there. This will send a message to everyone else in the room that the behavior is not acceptable. As you know, men tend to communicate more directly, and responding in a direct manner can help them wake up to what they're doing. So instead of sitting back and letting them explain things that you already know, interrupt and make it clear that you already have the knowledge and move on with the conversation. You know, you can say something like, hey, I'm clear on that subject and here's how it works. Obviously, find your own words that fit your style. You can anticipate this by starting to give little nudges or warnings to some men who might have a tendency to mansplain. When they do it, you can jump in and say things like, okay, I'm going to continue, and if there is still a question, we can address it then. Or, Eric, hey, I appreciate the observation, and I've got this. Or, I hear your point of view, this reminds me that maybe I should share more about my background that you still don't know about. Don't be apologetic, just make it clear that you've got a handle on it and don't need their input. To soften it up, you can also tweak these remarks and add humor to them. It still puts them in their place but won't feel like it's too harsh. So you could say, oh yes, I know you're eager to jump in, John. I am just not ready to leave the stage yet, so just wait a little longer, okay? Or another thing would be, oh yes, I can feel the wheels spinning out there, James, but just put a brake to them for now. I've been spinning those wheels for a while myself. Hold on. Make up your own and be witty and then just move on. Truly, some men don't even realize they're doing it and they don't mean to be rude. Also, know that often mansplaining or know-it-all behavior is stemming from a feeling of insecurity and a lack of confidence. So this way, they'll get the message, especially in front of a whole group, and you won't hurt their sensitive ego so much, which, by the way, I'm sure is huge. Benissimo. Now, maybe at times, you might have to be a little stronger in your message and set things straight. You could say something like, hey, Frank, I've realized that you often tend to interrupt me or try to talk over me when I'm sharing something. I need you to let me finish before jumping in. I also hope that you can take advantage of the information and experience that I and everyone else have here to share on this subject, since it's going to also be important for you to perform well in your position. And if this might seem a little strong to you, know that it's not. If you have reached the point where you need to have a one-on-one conversation with him, you know what? He probably has been doing this for quite a while and still doesn't get it. So don't feel awkward about it. He sure didn't when he interrupted you. And some people might need a stronger approach to sink that message in a little deeper. Now, another point that needs to be brought up here is that you need to create group support for this. And that doesn't mean it has to be only from other women. If you're a man or a woman who witnesses mansplaining, don't be a silent bystander. Speak up for them just as you would want to have them speak up to help you when facing something similar. Look at me, I am doing this video for that same purpose. This will create a culture where that kind of behavior is not acceptable. Recruit help from others when and where you can. It takes a village to stop it and reinforce the value of women. When the workplace supports you in stopping mansplaining, it will make it easier for everyone to feel comfortable addressing it, reclaiming your power, and put men on notice. Finally, you can do all this and the mansplaining just doesn't stop. It can be hard to change a behavior when it has been done for years or generations. Regardless, calling it out will promote understanding and slowly shift someone's perception. It also enhances the recognition of your own values and development. If we want things to change, we need to start changing them ourselves. And please now share in the comments below ways that you have addressed mansplaining by using these methods or others, so everyone can benefit. That's it. To download the key steps mentioned in this video, follow the link in the description below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like button, share with your friends, and make sure to subscribe for additional updates. And if you want more, click on the link below. You can schedule time with me for coaching and get some practice on this subject or more. Ci vediamo. A presto. Ciao.